Welcome to WXTV. We're here at this old home to once again talk about lead. Working in homes built prior to 1978 require that certain rules and procedures be followed. In weatherization, we operate under two rules: the Department of Energy's Lead Safe Weatherization, or LSW, and EPA's Renovation, Repair, and Painting Rule, or RRP. Let's head in and go over one of the most common weatherization tasks: setting up containment for interior work. Containment is designed to keep dust from migrating outside the work area. In weatherization, under the LSW rule, containment is always required, regardless of the size of disturbance. We use de minimis sizes to give us guidance as to how much containment to use. If, for instance, you're planning on disturbing less than 6 square feet per room interior, you may be able to get by with a level 1 or lower level containment. Level 1 containment is just enough plastic to contain the dust and debris from the job. There's no minimum set here. A good example of a level 1 containment might be taping a plastic bag underneath the thermostat that you're going to change out for a client, just to catch that debris. Another example of a level 1 containment might be taping some plastic up below that same job. Sometimes a higher level of containment is necessary. If you're disturbing an area equal to or greater than 6 square feet per room, a level 2 or RRP containment is required. And the same is true for windows. If you're working on windows or window components, that type of containment is necessary in both rules, regardless of the size. On this window, much of the work has already been done, but we'll show you what an appropriate level 2 or RRP containment would look like for removing the trim around the window to gain access for some air sealing measures. The first step for setting up a containment is to move anything out of the way that may get dust on it. So we'll do that. Now that we've got everything moved out of the way, we can start laying our plastic out. And the minimum guideline here is that we lay out 6 feet of plastic from the edge of our work area. Our work area is the window, so we would come 6 feet out from this edge. We would come 6 feet out from the edge here. And obviously we can't come 6 feet out from this edge because we hit a wall, but we would bring our plastic all the way up to that wall. And we'll tape all the way around those edges. So there you have it. This is a level 2 containment for a job like this. It's enough that it'll collect the debris from this job, and it's also going to make cleanup at the end of the job a lot easier. Floor plastic may be enough for this job, but over here we have a window retrofit to do, which means we're using high-speed tools. And using an IR camera, we noticed that some of the stud bays were missing insulation. So we're going to drill from the inside and fill those up as well. Plus, sitting right adjacent to our work area is a rather large bookshelf that our crews don't feel comfortable moving. So we're going to build some vertical walls out of plastic and go with a slightly higher level of level 2 or RRP containment. Okay, so we've got everything moved out of the way. We've got the register taped up just so it doesn't cause problems with the plastic. Got a few rods sized properly. Let's start laying out plastic. We'll lay this section out flat so we can build our door. So there you have it. We've got our containment set up. We're integrated with our floor plastic. We typically like to use a 6 mil plastic on the floor, and you can either go with a 4 or a 6 on the walls. That's really your preference and the amount of work that you're going to be doing and how long you're leaving it up. We've got our doorway in over here, our two-layer doorway, so we've got a door flap on the dirty side to capture all that debris so it doesn't move right through our eye door, but we still have access to and from our containment. So we'll just clean up some of these edges here and point out a few things as we're doing it. The first one is that the rods are on the inside. Now there's a bit of a debate about which way to do that is best, but really having them on the inside creates a much more durable containment. You do have to clean off those rods at the end of the job though, because you're going to get dust all over them. When you put them on the outside, it makes it a lot more difficult to put up and a lot more difficult to work within it. So something to keep in mind. I guess that's really your preference there. We'll clean these up so that nobody trips on them. And the other thing to point out here is that we left a little bit of an access to the outside. We had to get right up next to the wall there in order to blow that last cavity, but it should be enough that we can get in and out of it with just a little bit of wiggling. Well, there you have it. We've covered interior containment from the very simple level one containments to the much more complex level two or RRP style containments. It's up to you to keep the dust from spreading to the rest of the home. And the type of containment you choose is going to be dependent on the type of job that you're embarking on, the type of tools that you use, how high up in the air that job is, and the proximity of that job to living areas or things that you don't want to clean. There are minimum standards for this laid out in the LSW and RRP guidelines, but there's no recipe to follow. It's up to you to choose the proper containment. And thanks for watching.